At the end of this extremely difficult year, I am so incredibly grateful that despite all the challenges that have been thrown our way this year, thanks to you, our generous supporters, we've been lucky to have had a very successful year with Running for Premature Babies. Despite not being able to come together for any physical running events this year, our community spirit is very much alive and well. This year, we've expanded our reach, both in terms of the hospitals that we support and the geographical locations where people are lacing up their shoes and running for us. This year, we've welcomed more people from the premature baby community into our Running for Premature Babies family than ever before. So many parents of premature babies, both living and lost, have run with us and fundraised for us, banding together in love and support. And there's been so many more stories of hope, of people who've been inspired by our cause to prioritize their own fitness, directly benefiting their physical and mental health. So some of the highlights this year have been Quinn Darragh and Luke Stewart's superhuman English Channel swim, which raised $150,000. Ash North's extraordinary challenge to run 30 half marathons in her 30th year to raise $30,000 for Running for Premature Babies. Our Running for Premature Babies virtual run, our first ever virtual event, which brought in 700 people from around the country and beyond, which raised $76,000. The virtual City to Surf brought in $5,000, with City to Surf legend Paul Summerhayes running his 50th City to Surf for our cause. And the Premier Marathon Challenge, which has seen 570 people complete a marathon in either a day, a week, or a month this November. Incredibly, this event has brought in another $210,000. With the funds we've raised this year, we've been able to provide 12 months of research, neonatal research at the Royal Hospital for Women, a Narva ventilator, a baby Leo humidity crib, and a baby log ventilator for the Royal Hospital for Women, a neonatal vehicle for Queensland, which will be transporting prematurely born babies from rural areas to and from Brisbane for neonatal care. And we've provided 3 humidity cribs and a resuscitation cot for the Alice Springs Hospital neonatal unit. All of this equipment and research will directly benefit hundreds of premature babies from right around Australia. This would not be possible without you, our generous supporters. And so on behalf of the neonatal units that we support, and on behalf of all premature babies and their families, thank you and happy Christmas.